Good morning, children. Today we will study about electron gain enthalpy, or call it electron affinity, in short EA. It is denoted by delta difference, e.g. electron gain, H for enthalpy. I made arrow this way. S stands for the term enthalpy. What is enthalpy? You will be taught in detail in the chapter thermodynamics. Here you don't worry. For you at this level, simply enthalpy means energy, not exactly, I wrote nearly same as energy. So for this chapter for you, enthalpy means energy at this point of time. So what is electron gain enthalpy? It is the enthalpy change, energy change, when an isolated gaseous atom accepts an electron to form a gaseous anion. I repeat, enthalpy change, energy change taking place when an atom which is isolated in the gaseous form accepts an electron to form a gaseous anion. Fine. Say here you have any atom X in the gaseous form. It gained electron, got converted into X minus anion in the gaseous form. What all delta H, energy change, took place is called our enthalpy. Electron gain enthalpy, electron gain enthalpy, or call it EA, electron affinity. Means during the process of addition of an electron to an isolated gaseous atom and that converting to anion, what all energy change took place is called electron affinity in simple words, which is precisely electron gain enthalpy, the name is indicating itself. Unit kilojoule per mole. Children, actually you have been taught this in class 10 also. Now see here. Generally, it is an exothermic process. Energy is released generally, say in 95% cases. So energy is released. That's why even in class 10, if you remember, you had the definition, it's the amount of energy released. That was in general, but not always, children. Say for example here, I'll explain you. That's why I'm telling you energy change. Maybe in some case it is required also. You never know. So we'll see. So I repeat, enthalpy change taking place. Energy change taking place. Now, you have an atom, say, example O, in the gaseous form. It added with an electron and got converted into O minus anion, gaseous. So what energy was released? It was found to be an exothermic process. Energy was released and we call it first EA, EA1, or precisely call it delta EG. H means electron gain enthalpy and 1 stands for in the first case. Right? Since I am saying it was found to be exothermic process, energy was released. So some value was there, minus X kilojoule. Minus stands means energy was released. Energy is being released out of the system. Is being thrown out of the system. So it is minus. System is losing energy, releasing energy. So minus. Once I had O minus and now I want to add further electron, it got converted into O minus minus. This time, children, it was difficult to add up electron. Rather, I had to provide energy. It required energy. Energy was to be supplied to convert that, to add up this electron and convert it into O minus minus. So this step was found to be endothermic. Means energy was provided, added, supplied. Added means plus. So plus Y kilojoule, any value, I don't know, just positive. That much I know, energy was provided. I am calling it EA2, second step. As you used to have your IP1, IP2, same way here, EA2, the second step. Or call it precisely, more correctly, delta means change, e.g. electron gain enthalpy, and 2 stands for the second step. Or say in simple words for understanding purpose, EA1, EA2, first step, second step. This was exothermic, this was endothermic. Some energy was released, here energy was provided. Fine. Then children, we have the term like, as we had first IE, second IE, third IE, or first IP, second IP, third IP. Similarly here, I had atom A, got converted to A minus, first step. A minus converted to A minus minus, second step. And then A double minus goes to A triple minus, third step. As I said, normally energy is released in the first case. So normally value is expected to be negative. Energy to be released. Second case, once it has minus charge, difficult to add up electron, energy is provided. So add it up, so it will be positive value. Further, difficult to add up electron, hence energy will be added and some positive value. So first EA, second EA, third EA, in simple words, which again I'm saying precisely is delta EG H. H1, H2, H3, likewise. So children, I wrote the second EA is always positive. There's no exception. Third EA, always positive. So I just wrote second and third EA is always positive. Then what all factors? I said it can be in some cases positive. So I said, hold on. I'll explain you. But generally it is minus, as I said. Now factors. One is size. Children, smaller the size, it is easy to attract the electron and add up. Easily electron gets added up and large amount of energy is released. So smaller size, more amount of energy is released because electron is added up easily. Hence, small size, EA higher. So, with the size, it is inversely proportional. Bigger size, difficult to attract electron, add up electron, energy is hardly released. Smaller size, easily attracted, easily added, large amount of energy given out. So, it is inversely proportional. Smaller size, higher the value. Nuclear charge, similar. If nuclear charge increases, easy to attract electron, easily added up, large amount of energy given out. So nuclear charge, directly proportional. Configuration, very important factor. If stable, large positive value. This point is there. See your second period, same outermost shell, lithium, beryllium, I'm moving here. Children, it is first group, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and then zero. One electron in the outermost shell, 2s2, 2s1, 2s2, and likewise. From here to here, the size is decreasing. This should have high value. It has high value. Right? But then, high in what terms? There was some value, electron was added, some value was in negative, given out. Here, children, due to fully filled subshell, forget about the size factor. Configuration here is playing very important role. So here, there was some value, normally energy is released, something was in minus, I expected in minus. Fine. Low, high, whatever, it had to be low value because this big in size not will attract electron. So not much amount of energy will be released, but at least it could add up, some energy was released. Here is fully filled case. S2 very stable, fully filled. Hence, it is difficult to add up electron. This will have some value, positive. What value? I don't know. You need not. Then here it is, like P1 means not as stable as it was this. So finally, energy was released. As I told you, 95% cases, electron is added up, energy is released. So something in minus. Come here, 2P2, something in minus. Rather, it will be some higher value. Because when you move from here to here, size decreasing, electron adding coming up more easily, getting attracted more easily, more energy will be released. So let me say it's a bigger minus. Okay, fine. Then come here. It is very stable. P3, very stable. So value is something in positive because it is difficult to add up electron. Difficult to add up electron, children. It does not want to add up electron. Hence, you have to provide energy to the atom to get electron get added. Hence, some value in positive. What value? We are not concerned. But we know for sure it will be positive. It will not be released because it will not add up under normal conditions. It requires energy to get that electron embedded, added up. Right? Hence something positive. Here to here when you moved P4, there's no case of extra stability. Hence something in minus, no doubt. So whatever's there, it's okay. Come to F, it will have further high value because for a small size, easy electron is added up. So it has further high value. I have made bit bigger negative. It will be negative, electron will be released, but something in negative. Then children, come to this neon, S2P6, octet complete. Very difficult to add up electron, it doesn't want to add up electron. It doesn't want to lose its stability, which was due to octet. Hence, we have to provide a large amount of energy to get the electron added up. It requires a lot of energy. So lot of energy is added up, given up. With the result, the value will be in positive, right? And possible also a high value, right? Could you understand, children? So electronic configuration also plays an important role. Here what happened? Lithium, fine, as I told you, 95%, 96% energy is released. So energy was given out, fine, whatever value was there. I come from here to here, smaller size, something more in minus. Here to here, something more in minus. Here to here, something more in minus. Further move, something more in minus. But S2, this beryllium, S2, very stable, fully filled, S. Hence, the value is something in positive, would not like to add up electron. P3 would not like to add up electron, hence in positive. And neon, octet complete, very high value in positive. So I hope these points are clear to you. I stop here for this video. And in my next video, we'll just do one or two questions and then I'll go to other properties. So I hope it is clear. Please, I stop here. Try to understand. And yes, I'll give you a photo of this. You will note down all the points. You will keep your all notes ready.